Hi there, everybody. It's Ramona here again from Connect to Your Angels. I hope you all had a great week this past week. Some of you may still be feeling some of the after effects from a lot of the stuff that's been happening worldwide, with what happened in Boston and the earthquakes and building collapse that happened in Bangladesh. There's been a lot of things, and I know a lot of people are feeling that and feeling the effects of that. So continue to, heal, work with your heart chakra, process any emotions that you might be having, and know that you are definitely not alone in that. And of course, call on your angels to help you with anything that you might need in the way of comfort or healing or, whatever those emotions are that you need help dealing with. So I just wanted to mention that because I do know a lot of people are still having, effects from all of that. Also, we had a beautiful full moon on Thursday. It was gorgeous and definitely worked with that. Full moons are great for releasing, and their effects can actually be felt 4 days leading up to the full moon and even 4 days after. So depending on when you're watching this, you still might be on the end of that full moon, and you can definitely work with releasing anything that no longer serves you. So write out your list, write down, are you angry about something? Are you frustrated about something? Are you anxious? Are you worried? Do you have guilt? Do you have, any other feelings that you're harboring, and write out what the whole situation is. Say, I'm willing to finally release this. And then you can symbolically burn that list under the light of the full moon. So it's a great way to just release. If you don't want to go ahead and do the whole burning thing, you don't have to. Even the act of just writing it out and getting it out of you instead of stuffing it down is a great way to release and to, do some spiritual house cleaning of sorts. So continue working with that. I'll be sending out a reminder on the new moon, which is when it's time to manifest. So you can make your list of all the wonderful things that you want to bring into your life and work to manifest those on the new moon. So that'll be in a couple of weeks. All right, so this is going to be the reading for April 29th to May 5th. And with the energy now shifting into spring, finally, I think we might be safe to say, I might be jinxing it, but I think our snow is finally gone. So spring has sprung, and I wanted to work with the fairy deck this week. So bring in the nice energy of the elemental realm. So we'll go ahead and get started with the fairies. So I'm going to shuffle as always, and we're going to choose our three cards. Okay. Alrighty, let's see what we have here. Okay, so beginning of the week. Ooh, this is interesting. Pregnancy. A lot of people sometimes panic a little bit when they see that card, especially if they are thinking they are done having their family, and they think, uh-oh, what's this all about? But really, it's about new beginnings, giving birth to new ideas or new creative inspiration that's going to hit you. So the beginning of the week, Monday, Tuesday, really tap into your guidance. You might be getting those pokes about, a new way of looking at something or a whole other way of going at something that maybe you hadn't considered before. And likely it's going to be a lot more efficient. I feel like it's, going to save you time. It's going to save you money by going at this a different way and having a new perspective. Now, if some of you are hoping to start a family or add to your family, this can also be indicative of an actual pregnancy. And so, pay attention to that. You might already have a knowingness about that even before, that's confirmed. So that's something else that you can pay attention to. And also, it's a time of transformation for a lot of you. I don't know if you can see in this card, there's the butterfly wings and butterflies in here, a metamorphosis. It's I feel like a lot of you over the winter months have kind of been in your little cocoon, your chrysalis, and things have been happening. You have done some spiritual work, self-healing, and it's like you're emerging now in springtime as this whole new you. So that is wonderful. Now spread your wings, let that new you emerge, show yourself to the world for who you really are. And this kind of echoes on some of the themes from past weeks where I talked about any of you who are, you know, undercover light workers, about getting yourself out of the spiritual closet and, you know, going forth into the world to share your gifts with others because you're needed. So don't keep it all in. Don't keep it under wraps. It's about now going forth into the world and sharing those gifts with others and being of service, which is your true path and purpose. Okay, so that's Monday, Tuesday. Ah, can't even talk today. Middle of the week. Wednesday, Thursday, we have Let Go. Let Go. I love the robin in there. I did finally see some robins. And I'll read to you what it says on that card. It says, as you surrender the need to control, your relaxed energy rapidly attracts your desires. And I think we even had this card or a very similar message last week. Because a lot of you are a bit of sort of control freaks or micromanagers or having to, you know, be on top of things. And this really echoes this card too, because what happens is when you are so close to something, you know, you're really invested in it, it's that proverbial, you can't see the forest for the trees, right? So if you step back a little bit and let go, then you see new, like I said, new creative ideas come to you. You might get new inspiration, a better way of doing things that's going to save time and money, all of that. So those two messages kind of go hand in hand a little bit. So letting go of, you know, your need to be in control of everything. And if you're working with your angels and asking for stuff, don't give them instructions on how to do it. That's their job. Just tell them what you want and then release from that and let them worry about how it's going to show up in your life and how they could bring that to you. Okay, because sometimes you would say, oh, please help me with this, but in our humanness, we only see, you know, tunnel vision, right? We figure we know how it's going to happen, how it's going to play out, how things are going to show up. But honestly, they can bring it to you in ways that you would never even have thought possible. So open yourself up to allowing that to happen and not feeling like you have to be so in control of the situation. I hope that makes sense for you, okay? So I know that's hard for a lot of people to back off a little bit. So do it in baby steps. You know, if it feels too hard to do it in a complete way, try to slowly distance yourself in a small little way until you feel comfortable with that. And then you can, you know, expand on that and make it on a wider scale. Okay, ooh, interesting. New career. This is for Friday, Saturday, Sunday. New career. I'll read you what it says. Your work focus is shifting in a positive, new, and successful direction. So this sort of ties in, again, with that message for the light workers. You know, a lot of you are wanting to make a shift, maybe not giving up your day job completely, but trusting in yourself and your abilities enough to know that, yes, you are capable. Yes, what you're doing is accurate. Yes, you can do this. You have all the resources. So just go do it now. Stop procrastinating. Stop thinking, well, I don't know. And you know, all those things that your ego will put into your head. Just go do it. Like I said before, it's the Nike swoosh, the logo. Just do it. So definitely, you know, stop waiting around thinking there's just one more thing that you need. That's not true. For others of you, you're feeling off. What's the word, off alignment or in misalignment with your true calling, your true path and purpose. You know when you are not doing or following your true path and purpose when you just, you know, it's a paycheck, right? You do what you do. You're like, this isn't really what jazzes me. I'm just doing it because, you know, I need the paycheck or whatever. When you know you are on your true path and purpose is when you are so excited to do what you do that, you know, hours could fly by and you just don't even notice, or you almost feel bad for taking money from people for your services or your product or whatever it is, because you just love doing it so much. Like, you just honestly, you know, you love it. So it's part of you. It really is a big chunk of you. Now, if you are trying to figure out what that is for you, there's a couple of ways that you can go about that. You can, first of all, you know, ask your friends and relatives. A lot of times they will know. They've seen what you get fired up about, what brings you joy, what makes you passionate. Ask them, you know, for some of their insights about that. But you can also work with your angels and take some time in meditation. And I don't mean you have to sit there for an hour, even just go for a walk in nature. And really think about the times in your life that you were so happy, so joyful doing things that, you know, like I said, it's those things where hours go by and you don't even happen to notice because you're just so engrossed in what you are doing. And that's a great way to sort of get in tune with what your true path and purpose is. So you can try some of that. And again, don't let your mind get in there and mess everything up, because a lot of us are very good at recognizing, you know, our inner guidance. We kind of have a feeling about things, but then our mind will get in there and tell you, well, you know, if you want to do this, that means you're going to have to go back to school and it's going to cost you this much money and it's going to take you this much time and da da da. It tries to talk you out of things, right? So don't let that happen. Try to really think this through without letting the ego mind get in there. Again, your job's to figure out what, and angel's job's to figure out how to bring it to you. Even if you don't think it's ever going to be possible in a million years, take that out of your head, okay? Take that out of your heart, because I'll tell you right now, miracles happen every day to people, every single day, and they're not any different than you or me. They're just everyday people. So why can't they happen to you? If you want something bad enough and you work with your angels and you work on manifesting it, it can show up. I'm telling you this because it happens all the time, and I get the emails from my clients, and you know, I've seen what can happen. So don't be a doubting Thomas. Definitely, you know, think about what would bring you so much joy, so much happiness, and then try to put that into action. And another great thing you can do is, if you're not quite sure what you're really, you know, wanting to do, or what I'm supposed to do, I hear that all the time. What am I here for? What am I supposed to do with my life? You know, imagine what you want your perfect day to look like from the minute you wake up in the morning and you open your eyes and your feet hit the ground. Write out what that perfect day would look like for you. You know, in terms of having how much control you want to have in your life, how much freedom you want to have, how much time do you want to devote to career, all of those things. And that will give you a good sense of what your values are. What is it that you really, what's important to you? You know, a lot of times people will say, well, I'm really realizing freedom is a big chunk of who I am. So I really don't want to have a job that I have to go to. I would rather be my own boss and be an entrepreneur of some sorts, you know, so I can control when I'm working, when I'm not working, and I don't have to answer to anybody. So feel that out. See what, go inside yourself a little bit and do some of that inner work so you can get at the meat and potatoes of who you are, and then you can start to work to put that into action, okay? So very much a week of creating, you know, really getting onto your creative side, letting go of some of that control so that creative stuff can flow, those creative juices can come to you. And doing a little bit of homework. As always, the angels love to give homework, but it's good, it's fun, and it's helps you really to get focused so you can, you know, work and expend energy where you need to, not on, you know, wasting it in other areas that you're just wasting your time, okay? So wishing you many, many angel blessings. Thank you once again for tuning in, and I will see you all here next week. Bye now.